Hey guys, it's Phoenix. I'm back on 18W07B. This is the 1.13 snapshot that was just released yesterday. It is just a bug fix snapshot, so not too much to report on. I do have a few things I want to show you at another time. I did a live stream last night, and I did go through a lot of the more technical aspects of the Trident. While Channelling and Impaling are two enchantments which are quite banal in themselves, I will touch base on three of the enchantments out of the four at the end of this video, just to give you guys a bit of a summary. But it's Riptides which are a little more interesting. So, give at P Trident and the NBT is as follows. The enchantment ID is 67 and the level is 1 up to 32,000, presumably. First of all, quick demonstration of the Trident. They do quite a bit of damage. So just to preface, I guess, I'm pretty sure Tridents are either going to be really hard to obtain, maybe in the new ruins that Minecraft shared on their social media, but I'm pretty sure they will be the new bow, essentially, new projectile. Nevertheless, let me share with you what Riptide actually does. So it has to be raining, and it needs to be a biome suitable for rain. So essentially, you need to have some form of water contact for it to work. Can be underwater too. I'm going to set it to rain, and luckily with the fail of this terrain generation, this will work. So I have it on level 1 at the moment, which is basically the default. If I shoot my Trident forward, I will move forward. It's pretty basic stuff. So let's change this to level 3. Level 3. And if I shoot forward, you can see I've actually moved pretty high. So there is some momentum. It's not static. However, obviously and more interestingly, if you make this level, let's say 300, and give this to you yourself, and you go towards this wall over here, you'll crash into the wall. I've actually couldn't actually move because I've sort of like rebounded back. And I've seemed to have missed the wall and I'm all the way into the sky. This is actually a terrible idea. And I'm pretty sure, okay. So there was a bit of lag there. Chunks didn't load. Essentially what it did was it just kept pushing me forward, but it's just come to a halt right now. I should actually, what's cooler is I can shoot to the ground and I will move to the ground. Slowly, because it's at 300 increments, right? There we go. So, I seem to have actually gone back to spawn. Nice. And what I've noticed is it's almost at a one block to one level ratio. This is not really apparent if you have a really low enchantment level, because it will take more of the momentum into account in the calculation. And just to prove this to you, I can set this to about 10,000. And if I look all the way up and press my F3 screen, I'm actually going to shoot all the way up to 10,000. There's really no momentum involved, especially if it's really high, which makes a lot of sense. And one thing you should never do is never look at a wall. Exactly. If you have a really high Riptide enchantment level, never look at a wall because it will crash your game. Let me just demonstrate that right now. Yeah, it's frozen. So the idea is it's trying to, well, Minecraft is presumably trying to calculate where you're meant to go. And because the enchantment level is so high, it actually has no idea where to place you. Also, negative enchantments for Riptides don't do anything. It actually does not release from your hand. Okay, so I've been asked also by some viewers to test out a skeleton holding a Trident. And in fact, I haven't done this yet. I'm actually wondering if it will. No, it doesn't. Okay, so it does behave just like any other mob. Oh no. Please don't. Please don't. Okay. Yeah, so the Trident will not work if you don't pull it all the way back, which is kind of interesting. But the idea is a skeleton, just like any other mob, will never use its item that is not given. So, like, if you give it to a zombie, it will actually never shoot the Trident. It will just fling it at you, like an axe. Like, it'll just wield it at you, try and swing it at you. Which is one of the functions of a Trident, but of course, who's going to do that with a Trident unless it's melee? Also, I figured out that a Trident will fling itself further, the higher the Riptide enchantment. I think this is more of a side effect to the idea of flinging yourself. I'm not sure whether the Trident itself goes further. Just quickly talking about channeling, it needs to be thundering. It's only a level 1, so it's 100% efficiency. Loyalty is also 100% efficiency. I first anticipated it to be a percentage chance for the Trident to come back, but that sort of just defeats the purpose of it being level 1. So if you want to have loyalty, why not just always come back? So it's just the speed. And lastly, impaling is for mobs that are naturally underwater. So it's the more specific type of sharpness, so like Bane of Arthropods, but it will be more damaging to underwater mobs, not mobs that are found underwater. So not a creeper that's swimming, essentially. Otherwise, hope you guys enjoyed this video. Just my review of Tridents that I discovered along with Phantoms, which are kind of boring right now. So I won't go into them into too much detail until more about them is released in Minecraft 1.13. Otherwise, thank you all for watching. Leave a like, subscribe for more creative content. Take care.